combination of tactical fighter group and strike reconnaissance group moved one of the world's longest established air forces beyond the concept of organized combat. This is what I live for. I never quit.
Does a high G pull up into the vertical with some vertical rolls. He will end off with a tumbling maneuver at the top. The tumble has its origins in the 1960s, known as a Lomshavak, and it's now available in many variations that pilots have developed over the years. Jefferies is 64 years old and has been flying aerobatics since 1984. And in addition to doing airshow performances, Mark runs a very busy airfield in the UK. What you're seeing right now is called a horizontal flat spin, which is just executed as he rolls on the downline and pulls up into a vertical tumble. Another tumbling maneuver, however, this time on the vertical line. Mark's skill as an aerobatic pilot is proven by a successful career as an unlimited aerobatics pilot. He has represented Great Britain in competitions over many years, during the course of which he has won medals at several international competitions. In the UK, Mark has frequently won national championships, first winning at unlimited level in 1994 in an aeroplane that he built himself called the Laser 200. Mark was the winner of national aerobatics titles in 2005, 2006 and 2007, and 2007 and 2009 saw him in the top 10 in the World Championship, and in 2011 he placed third in the World Air Masters Championship. As he pulls up into the 45 degree with a combination of flick or snap rolls, as they're known in America, into a tumbling maneuver. And as he exits this tumble, he is now positioning himself for a first ever frisbee, an inverted frisbee performed here this week at Avalon. And this is an Australian airshow first. As you see, he'll pull up to a 45 degree, he'll invert the aircraft, and he'll frisbee out towards the north. Isn't that incredible? And we're going to cross over live to the cockpit and ask Mark, Mark, what do you love?
I love Avalon.
Mark's no stranger to Avalon, and he's been performing here. His first time was in 1998, flying a Yak 52. And in 2013, he flew with the awesome Extra 330 as a solo performer, and then with Tom Cassells in 2015, flying the awesome Global Stars, performing in the awesome Extra 330s. Mark's flying the Extra NG, which was unveiled at Oshkosh in July 2019 as an all-new, all-composite, technically advanced and innovative aircraft type. NG stands for Next Generation. The awesome Extra NG registration Victor Hotel X-Ray Echo Oscar serial number 7 is the first of this type to be imported into Australia, and it arrived in September 2020, making its first public viewing at the Royal Aero Club's open day on the 3rd of October at Jandakot Airport. And Mark's now positioning for his pylon run through the pyros. Mm-hmm. those of you that were here last night, that was simply spectacular with the sunset sky that we had. Mark's now going to position for a 45 degree upline, doing what's known as a crossover snap. It's a positive snap transitioning into negative snaps.
There's so many things I like about you. I just don't know where to begin. Okay, well, I like the way you look at me with those beautiful eyes.
And Mark is now positioning for a photo opportunity where he will present the aircraft in knife edge flight, in upright flight, and inverted flight. And for his final maneuver, he's going to end off with his signature vertical tumbling maneuver. What a great way to end the display of the awesome X-ray NG. That concludes our show, and thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of your show today.
Tony Moncler.
This is the talking point of Avalon. These guys have just thrilled everybody, not only with their flying, but their professionalism and their friendliness. We're talking about the Republic of Korea Black Eagles from the ROKOF, the Republic of Korea Air Force supersonic jet trainers. The first time they have brought their team and their display to Australia. We are witnessing something truly unique here at Avalon. They put on an absolutely stunning show. They have a highly visible display livery. They've got an onboard camera system, and they display smoke. And not only display smoke, but precision aircraft flying.